Why does God allow evil? If he is in control, then isn't he the cause of all the bad things in the world?
Yeah, it's a great question. This question is, it's one of the ones that I personally wrestle with the most because, you know, you look around at the brokenness of the world and you go, my goodness, how could there be a loving God? How could there be a God, you know, that's in control? And the first thing is to say this. It's been called the rock of atheism, this question. It's like the thing that's always going to take down theism, which is the belief in God. And there's a few things to say. The first one is there's free will that God has given humankind. And with free will, we do a lot of messed up stuff. Without it, there wouldn't be love, in a sense. And so there was a bit of a cost-benefit ratio that was being calculated at the beginning where God creates humankind who are sentient beings who think through what they do and they're conscious and they're moral creatures who get to make decisions. And how was this going to play out? Well, as Dallas Willard said, if you have a world like that, you create people like that, you're going to probably have a world very similar to ours, which is people who make narcissistic, selfish decisions and kill people and destroy people and step on people in order to get ahead in life and all of that, to become rich and greedy and cheat and all this. So the second thing, though, is to say, if you're using this as an argument against the existence of God, you have to be very careful because, as I said earlier, the fact that you believe in evil and suffering means that you have a category called evil or suffering. And without God, that category doesn't exist. So for instance, if all we are is the product of naturalistic evolution, meaning unguided evolutionary development over millions of years, then the moral construct you have would have to be the product of that development. But that doesn't make sense because there's so many things you and I believe that according to nature, nature would never hardwire into our brain. That it's almost like you have super nature needing to tell you that certain things are right and wrong. Because a shark, the way sharks have babies are by raping other sharks. But we don't call it rape. We just call it sharks doing what sharks do, right? When a lion kills a zebra, we don't call it murder. We call it lunch, you know, whatever. So, but we don't, somewhere along the line, we're not zebras, and why? So you have to answer the question where you even got the category called evil. Where did you come up with the idea that when someone goes into a movie theater and shoots up a bunch of people and you go, see, God doesn't exist. Where did you get the idea that shooting up a bunch of people in a movie theater was decisively and objectively wrong? The fact that you have a category to put God on trial means that someone actually gave you the category. Or else, shooting up a bunch of people in the theater, it's just the way nature's red in tooth and claw. It's tough, it's difficult. Moving on. Like, dude, your only thing in life is to protect your family and get your genes into the next generation and survive. Survival the fittest. It doesn't matter. I got five fingers. I will kill anything with four because that's my right. But the fact that you don't believe that, the fact that you think you should stand up for people who are oppressed means something else is going on. So, when you look, you've got to at least ask the question, why does this universe bug me the way it is? And that means I know I'm comparing it to something else, something bigger. The other thing is about this is here's the beautiful thing about Christianity. Christianity is not the only thing that needs to answer this question. Every other religion has to answer this question. Atheism's answer is bad. I just talked about it. Well, I don't know. There's no God and we're just animals, whatever. Well, that doesn't work. That's actually contradictory. Eastern philosophy is no good because it's karmic, which means all the suffering that you have in your life, so when I went to India, I got off the airplane and I tried to give money to beggars on the street, women who were sitting there with babies, and they said, don't relieve their suffering. Because if you relieve their suffering, they have to live this back out in the next life because that's them paying karma back. So it's a worldview that actually doesn't deal with suffering. Here's what Christianity does. It says, it doesn't tell you every single scenario of God saying, here's why this happened, here's why this happened. It doesn't answer all those questions. What it does do is says, first, be humble enough to understand that you don't necessarily know what's going on in the universe all the time, which is why ancient philosophical writers never said there's so much evil and they saw way worse than we do. there's so much evil, ergo God doesn't exist. They said, there's so much evil, I must not be able to understand what the gods are doing. There's humility until the Enlightenment. Mm-hmm. And the Enlightenment came along, and we thought our mind is the most important thing, and so we should be able to rationalize. And the last thing is we here's what we know. It's not that God doesn't care, because God became a human being in the person and work of Jesus and actually took evil onto himself and dealt with all the pain and agony of the world in order that you might go to a place ultimately where there is no pain and evil anymore through the cross and the resurrection of Jesus. So. Right.